I have something heavy on my heart. The young people, that they ought to understand the fact that education is the most important thing that they can have. And for so many of them, we've been lied to and told all we have to do is be a great athlete or be a great singer or a great rapper, and we'll have it made. What do we need with an education? Well, it's been said too often that if you want to hide something from a black man or a black person, put it in a book. And it's becoming true, because we think that the streets is what's going to save us. But the streets is going to eat us up and not even spit us out. It's going to devour us. So my heart is telling all young people, go to school, get an education, understand that the most powerful thing you can do is educate your mind. The bravest thing you can do is not go with the flow of what everybody else is doing, but going with the bend that God put in you. He gifted you. He gifted all of us, but we have to refine that gift. We have to cultivate that gift, and then we have to take it and serve other people. We have forgotten that as we climb the ladder, we should be lifting. Lift people up as you climb. Don't go up and brag about what you have. All of your worth is on your neck and in your ears and in your mouth. Let your worth be in your mind and use it to uplift other people.
Growing up in Indiana, I used to tune in to the University of Indiana basketball games. And that was my favorite play. I used to root for him, and when he did well, I felt good. When he didn't do well, I didn't do too good. But I say I did better more times than I did not do good. I'd like to introduce to you, before I get started, my wife. You know, it's been said that behind every successful man is a good woman. I kind of disagree with that a little bit. Simply because when I read my Bible, and I think it's the same one that everybody here read, it said that God put Adam into a deep sleep and took a rib.
Oh, come on, Harry.
Now, I took kinesiology.
Come on.
And I know that if it's from the back, it's the coccyx bone and not the rib bone. The rib comes from the side. So I'd like to say that beside every successful man, there is a great woman.
All right.
And I have one beside me, my wife, Carla. Let me say this also. I'm a very successful man. I'm successful. But let me clear it up. I'm not successful because I have a lot of money. Because I don't. I'm retired. We have to have, we're on a budget. We have to make ends meet. We have to make sure that money lasts a whole month. And I'm not successful because I have a lot of material things. Because I don't. I'm also not successful because I have a beautiful, intelligent, wonderful wife. Now that I do. But I'm successful because in my life, after trying all sorts of things, I developed a relationship with God.
All right.
And he has made me a success. I stopped looking at resources, because resources dry up on you. Money run out, house, you might lose your house, might lose your car, might lose your job. And I started looking at the source.